Hi there, let us see how we can create a salt water battery. These are the 5 small plastic containers or bigs, and these are zinc and copper plates. We have connected 4 pairs of zinc and copper plates. As you can see, copper and zinc is connected with a wire. So we have created 4 pairs of these wires. Zinc plate and one copper plate at the end. So this will be the end of the wire for our connection, and we have poured salt water in all these plastic bigs. Then we will be placing these wires into these bigs, all the plates, and then we will connect one end of the wire to a LED. So this is our LED. The smaller leg is the negative of the LED and the longer leg is the positive of the LED. We will connect the wire coming from the zinc plate to the negative leg of the LED, the smaller leg of the LED. And we will connect the wire coming from the copper plate at the other end to the longer leg of the LED. So this will complete the circuit of our battery, and then instantly you will see that the LED glows. So this is how the salt water battery will work. Now let us try to measure the voltage that is generated in our experiment. We have a zinc plate at one end of the battery and a copper plate at the other end of the battery connected to a wire. We'll use a multimeter for measurement. We have to set the knob to DC volt, and I have set it to 20 volts. So up to 20 volts it can measure. The multimeter has a COM port and a red colored wire attached to the other port. The COM port has black wire to it. So we will connect the wire from the COM port of our multimeter to the wire coming from the zinc plate. And then we will connect the red probe of the multimeter to the wire coming from the copper plate. So this is how we can measure the voltage. In my experiment, it turned out to be around 3.8 volts. Now let us try to measure the current flowing through this salt water battery. We'll use the multimeter for that. We will set the multimeter's knob to the ampere region. I have set it to 20 milliampere. There is also a setting for micro amperes. You can set it on the micro amperes, that can give you a more accurate reading. So first of all, as in the case of the counting of voltage, we will connect the wire coming from the zinc plate to the COM port, that is the black wire, the black probe coming from the multimeter. We will connect it to that, and then we will connect the red cable coming out of the multimeter to the smaller leg of the LED, that is the negative of the LED, and we will connect the longer leg of the LED to the wire coming from the copper plate. So this is how we will connect the multimeter and the LED in series in this circuit. So if we connect this in series, then we can measure the amount of electricity flowing through the circuit. So in my experiment, I found that it was 0.1 or 0.2 milliamperes flowing through the circuit. So if you measure it in microamperes, you may get a more accurate result.